Hello, I'm John McGrath. I'm a producer for Flatland at Kansas City PBS, and I'm here to tell you about the local Kansas City horror film, The Stylist, directed by Gevargizian.
It's about a hairstylist who also happens to be a serial killer. She scalps her victims, and it's her way of kind of escaping and finding, trying to feel what it's like to be someone else. She like mentally unravels and it becomes a little too much for her. But the film's ultimately about her downward spiral. We made a short film that came out in 2016. We shot it, it feels like a million years ago now. Like a way to see like what the concept is. A lot of people ask, does it exist in the narrative in the feature? It doesn't exactly. It's kind of capturing the same time to me, so it can't like coexist together. But we have little things from the short in the feature for people who've seen it to kind of be like, oh, that was in the short. Just for anyone who is that a nerd, which us horror fans are, you know, geeky like that.
I don't think people realize in us, you know, just trying to make low budget films that it's kind of a family thing, isn't it?
Yeah. Cause it takes so much like passion. Cause we're not, none of us are getting paid great, or like us producers, we don't pay ourselves at all. So, you know, that even the people we pay our crew, but we know everyone that is there cause they want to be, because it's not like just a fat paycheck. And it takes so much work, especially once you get to the production, you know, the shoot. It's such an intense thing of all these people problem solving together, just naturally bonds you so much. Plus, from a personal point perspective for me, I wanted to make this movie for so long that like anyone who helps that happen to me, that's like very sentimental to me. It's not just like a professional thing, you know, at all. Very emotional about that stuff. With The Stylist, for me, it's not as much about society stuff, but what's crazy, I've read a lot of reviews and interpretations, and I'm like, what subliminal things are going on in my head that I didn't even know I was doing?
Look what I have. It's a good one, isn't it?
For me, it's more about, it's a character piece, and it's, so it's really personal and internal about how we view ourselves, which is nothing how anyone else sees us, and just like issues with identity, insecurity, anxieties, with social anxieties. It's all really about that kind of stuff. Luckily, we've seen a lot of people like connect to that. That's the most exciting thing. Not just that people are like, oh, it's fun and gross, but they're understanding like what we were trying to say with the character.
I just want to try it on.
It's just been a male dominated industry for so long. I think, you know, the kind of thing people say, the like, if you see it, you can be it, which sounds cheesy as hell, but it's true. If you never see something, you maybe never envision that it's possible. I think kind of everyone's responsibility that's higher up in film on projects to also think about hiring very equally, not just sex, but gender, but race and everything. So you have all kinds of perspectives involved in a group.
I need to look perfect.
Obviously, I want to do this no matter, like I've been working on this film for years for, I'm paying to make the movie at this point. So I think you, people that really love it will figure out how to keep doing it. You know, the money won't stop them.
That glass ceiling is a real bitch.